Hi, good morning. Let me take you through yet another paper wherein now my focus will be to exclusively devote some time on the software tools which are there and try to understand what these software tools are meant for bibliometric analysis, one. And number two, I want to even perform a comparative study. So this is the paper that I have chosen by Morel Munoz Jose A, and this is Herrera Viedma Enrique, and then this is Satiste Ban and Espoho, then Antonio Cobo Manuel J, published in 2020 with the title Software Tools for Conducting Bibliometric Analysis in Science and Up-to-Date Review. Now, not just the science, we are using it even in the management and the nursing schools also, though there are other tools which I'll be showcasing in my future videos. However, this is one paper which again gives you the in-depth knowledge about the software tools that we have got. I have taken this paper from the ResearchGate. It is available there. So kindly go ahead and you can look into it. I am not going to read line by line, though again this paper is a really good paper and you should read line by line. Otherwise, I'll take at least 4 hours to complete with this particular paper. So I'm not going to do that. Had it been a training program, I devote my time to read it and to make understand certain things so that we are aware as to how these individuals have taken care of. Now here they're saying that methods, what are they? Database that allows downloading the bibliography data, that's number one. I'm talking about these 4 or 5 points which have been highlighted. General bibliometric software are based on indexes and performance analysis. Then we have got what they call it as the SMA tools, and then R and Python libraries. Now, is this the only thing that is available or are they focusing on more? So if you will go ahead, they will be focusing more. First and foremost, they have chosen the databases out here, and under the databases, I'm going directly WOS, then Scopus. They have talked about Google Scholar, and MA is Microsoft Academic, and then the dimensions which is there. Now here subscription they have spoken, for WS you require it, for Scopus you require it, whereas Google free, Google Scholar is absolutely free, Microsoft is also free, dimensions free or under subscription. That means they have given you the trial period first and then you can carry forward. Then data to be downloaded, yes, this one does not allow because of the copyright kind of a thing. Then using the API, we will see what those are, and then the dimension. So records API formats they have given to you, so that's a good to know knowledge about these databases which are available for us. Now if I go further, now the software that they are talking about is also important to understand with the performance of the bibliometric analysis that is present over here. So if you go into further details, they have given you a nice table. Here we go. It's a very simple one, however not for the entire thing. For the there are categories for the software. First one, they are focusing on what they call it as the performance software. Under that you have got CR Explorer, Publish or Perish, and then you have got a CytoPy UI. This is in Python. Now here we go, operative system is Java. If you know Java, I mean it's not very difficult, you can take care, that's the one. Then Windows, Mac and Linux, and this one is the Python. So data source would be WOS, Scopus and the cross reference that is present. Similarly for the Publish and this one MA, and for Science2Py UI is used, meant only for WOS and Scopus, and the interfaces also they have present along with the versions and the year of the launching also. Now apart from this, they have discussed a lot about how these performance analysis is helping you and what you require it, which we will go through later on. First let us go ahead and understand whether these are the only tools for performance or you have got some more about it. So let's see what are the other tools which are available, and then maybe we can go into this one. Now you have got for a science mapping. Now, I would not use the word simply as saying that it is science mapping. Let's talk about mapping of the bibliometric analysis. And here they are talking about various tools which are called as the SMA tools. Okay, and these SMA tools you will be seeing are what? Bib Excel, then you have got BiblioShiny, then BiblioMaps, later on SpideSpace, SitNet Explorer, SkyMat, then SkyTool, and VOS Viewer is also available. The year of their launch is there, which who are the developers, operative systems are necessary if you understand, and the user interface. So here you can see that they are talking about the user interfaces also. Now, beneath this particular table, they have discussed in length about each and every tool that they have discussed under the SMA category. And we will see later on some more important parts of these things. I'm not entering into the details about these kind of maps which they are showcasing right now. We will see with those softwares later. However, there is more information that they have shared in their paper, and I have to go through this one. Now, this is characteristics of the libraries which are present for these particular packages also. So you can see, if you are aware of bibliometrics, especially in R, so you have got this particular programming language and software is bibliometric. If you go to Python, it will be called as BiblioTools, Cython in R, then MetaKnowledge in Python, then CytoPy in Python, then Cyto2Text is again in R. So we will see these things again in depth as to how they are performing the bibliometric analysis using these particular libraries. Apart from this, there are more to go from their side. They have, okay, comparative features. This is what I wanted to further go ahead, and they have made it very clear that let's go ahead and see the comparatives or features of these particular softwares that are available. Now here we go, and you can see they have really taken care to give us the information. One is the tools, second is the databases, later on others that we can really understand. So here, first one that they're talking about is basically, let me come over, that is General Bibliometric and Performance Analysis, CRE, WS does not, Scopus does not, the other. Okay, they are saying that yes, they do take care. Publish and Peril, this is the information as to which databases are using it. Cy2py, UI, only two of them are taking. Now similarly, Science Mapping, let's see what they are telling us. Comparative of the databases supported by the reviewed tools. That means these are the databases which use these particular tools. Then you can see the other one, Bib Excel. Let me just minimize it a little bit more so that you are able to see it in a proper manner. Yes, here you can now have a look at it. Then they're talking about Bib Excel. The other ones are the ProCite and Bib Excel. The BiblioShiny by these three databases, BiblioMaps only by WS and Scopus, SiteSpace is being taken care. So this is the most popular one, I think, which is being covered by majority of it, other than Google Scholar. Google Scholar, just to have a glance at it, uses only Publish or Perish, and then is CyTool. Okay, that's it. The rest of them, which are the paid versions, WOS, Scopus, Dimensions, if you will see, they are relying more on CR Explorer than Publish or Perish, Cy2py, PYUI, BibExcel, BiblioShiny. We will enter into these things more and try to understand. So you can see as to how the different tools are there and the comparative study with respect to their databases which are available. And here is the complete detailed report that they have given to you. So if you look, BibExcel, it's only meant for WS, WOS and Scopus. BiblioShiny covers WOS, Scopus as well as Dimension. BiblioMaps only for first two. Site space goes for all of the categories other than Google Scholar. Then you have got this is SiteNet Explorer, Sitemap, Site Tool, then VOS Viewer. They have described it over here. Then ProQuest uses only meta knowledge. Okay, so that's also a database that we have got. Then they are mentioning about the other. And surprisingly, we have mentioned Wikidata. Wiki also has a lot of things. Surprisingly, they have not added out here. Maybe in future, we can go ahead, we can add some more databases which are there like Eric, and even see how those things are also working over this part. And let's see any other thing that they have taken care of. Yes, they are talking about more comparative about pre-processing option of the reviewed tools. So here they have given to you whether filters are there or not. Now you see why I am discussing this particular paper is that when you perform a systematic literature review or go ahead with meta-analysis or meta-synthesis for writing a good review paper, you will see that these are the databases which help you a lot. Along with the databases, even tools are necessary. Otherwise, manually if you do it, it will take a lot of time, you know, creating your own Excel sheet and then developing those things. However, with these tools present in front of us, you can see duplicate documents can be taken care of, plural singulars are there, string distance, deduplication, time slicing, stop words, data addition, filters. Now if you do it, take care, in our programming we don't have the concept of filtering over there, though I know the rest of them we can handle it very clearly. Filtering part of it becomes very difficult. Okay, so one has to understand and see how to deal with those things also, other than through these tools which are available. So this is one part. The other thing that they're talking about is comparative of the analysis and visualization options that are available. So this is also something good to know information, that if you want to go ahead with thematic network, what are the softwares? Then if you want to go ahead with author network, reference network, other networks, evolution, performance, then burst deduction, then you have got spectrograph. These are all the technical terminologies. Let me tell you the various methods that we have got while you are performing the bibliometric analysis. We will see once I complete it, then you can carry, we will enter into that zone wherein the what are the various methods available, or what are the types of the bibliometric analysis, you will be entering into it. So visualizations, you have got spectrogram, timeline graph, bar graph, evolution graph. Now, these are also something which are important for us to know. It's not just the names of the softwares which are necessary for us, or the tools which are available, or the libraries which are available. Along with that, try to know what kind of a visualization is there in front of you. For example, timeline graph. Now, evolution graph, word cloud. Now, apart from these things, visualizations, through the visualization, you're moving towards what we call it as a building or creating your own double, you know, what I call it as visualization or digital visualization stories. So, you know, when you are going to interpret it and give the analysis, the interpretation of it, you will see the importance of these visualizations also side by side. Like, for example, a tree map, historiograph, strategic, evolution map. Now these are all quite new map. That's why I said when I was showcasing my Excel sheet, and I said that 2019 or 2020 Excel sheet, if you have possessed with you, you will see the kind of graphs which are available, the visualization tools which are available over there, and they are giving. Apart from that, thanks to the machine learning, artificial intelligence through Python or R, you will be seeing that yes, these kind of diagrams are also coming in. Neural networks, if you enter into that zone, you will see a lot of networking analysis that can be done through that area also side by side. Now similarly, I was talking about Excel star. Now in Excel star, definitely yes, when you talk about turf analysis or churning analysis or the sensory analysis, when you do, there are a lot of graphical things which are available for us. So you know, I have not yet completed with that particular playlist also, I need to resume and showcase the importance of that particular tool side by side. So here they're giving you the visualization names and what kind of graphical things can be understood through these particular tools or the libraries and the packages that are available. So here we go, and then they have discussed about it that yes, bibliometric databases would be these ones, then bibliometric and performance analysis, these are the tools, SMA tools are these ones, Python and R libraries are this one. So I think if you are able to understand this kind of a thing, you would be able to go ahead and try to build up your own bibliometric analysis, and I think this gives you a good introduction as to how the things are and in what manner you can use various databases or the tools which are available and the visualizations. I think with this introduction, we can kick ourselves more to understand about the citation analytics or the bibliometric analysis and proceed further into the domain also. So thanks a lot for watching. Keep watching for more videos from my end. Till then, thank you and take care.